Good morning, students. We are going to discuss 7th chemistry chapter 2, physical and chemical changes. In this session, we are going to discuss changes around us, types of changes. In types of changes, we are going to discuss the changes based on repetition, changes based on time taken, changes based on reversibility, and changes based on usefulness. Students, we have many substances around us. All these substances have certain properties such as state, size, shape, color, smell, temperature, composition, and structure, etc. When one or more properties of a substance become different, we say that a change has taken place in it. For example, melting of ice. Melting of ice, whereas it is solid, ice is a solid, whereas water is a liquid. So, melting of ice involves a change in its state from solid state to liquid state. So, changes takes place all around us. Some of the changes observed by us in everyday life are burning of candle and dissolving of potassium permanganate, ripening of fruits, and then oscillation of swing, and then changes in trees. So these changes in a substance does not occur on its own. There is always a cause which brings about a change in a substance. For example, ice does not melt on its own to form water. It must be given some heat to melt and change into water. If we keep the ice in the freezer, it is in solid state. If we keep out from the freezer, it turns into liquid state. Okay. So, here the cause, the factor is heat. So, some causes, that is some factors, light energy, heat energy, electricity, and force acting on the object, it turns into some changes. The changes may be in its physical property or maybe in chemical properties. Some examples for changes in our daily life. Formation of curd from milk. The formation of curd, milk taste and smell is different, and curd taste and smell and the composition also different. Okay, so formation of curd from milk is one type of change. Here, this change does not occur on its own. We add some curd into a milk, the milk fully converted into curd. Like that, the vegetables, the fresh vegetables, when we cooking, the colors also change, the smell also change, and then the taste also change. So, cooking of food also one type of change. And then drying of wet cloths into dry cloth. Okay, drying of cloths. In the change, here the cause, we does not apply any heat to the cloths. It takes a heat from the atmosphere, from the sun, and then ripening of fruits, rusting of iron also examples of changes in our daily life. The rusting of iron, the iron take the oxygen from the atmosphere, it turns into iron oxide. This is known as a rust. So, rusting of iron also one type of change in our daily life. So, based on their occurrence, speed, reversibility, there are different types of changes. So, the types of changes can be classified into changes based on repetition, changes based on usefulness, and then changes based on reversibility, and then changes based on time taken. Changes based on repetition. Certain kind of changes which repeat at a fixed interval of time. Some changes do not occur at a fixed interval of time. So based on the repetition, the changes can be classified into two ways, that is periodic change and non-periodic change. Periodic change. Changes which repeat after a fixed interval of time are known as periodic changes. For example, change in day and night occur at a fixed interval of time. And a change in season also takes place after a fixed interval of time. Such kind of changes that repeat after a fixed interval of time are called periodic changes. Some other examples, the oscillation of pendulum and then heartbeat and then change in phases of moon, occurrence of low tide and high tide, it also take the regular interval of time. Okay, these are examples for periodic changes. And some changes does not occur on a fixed interval of time, which do not repeat at a fixed interval of time. This is known as non-periodic changes. For example, volcanic eruption, flood, it may occur at any time. It does not take a regular interval of time. So, volcanic eruption and flood and then blowing of rivers, blowing of flowing of rivers and blowing of air, these are also example for non-periodic change. And earthquake also example for non-periodic, it may occur at any time. So these are examples for non-periodic changes. Next we are going to discuss changes based on time taken. Some of the changes occur over a long period while some occur in very short time. So based on the time taken, we can classify the changes into two types, that is fast changes and slow changes. Slow changes, changes that takes a very long time for their completion is known as slow changes. For example, rusting of iron is a slow change and the growth of a child into adult is also a slow change. Some other examples are ripening of fruits, germination of seeds from the seeds, it turned into plant or tree. Okay, and then curdling of milk and then blooming of flower also example for slow changes. And formation of fossil fuels, it takes a millions of years. So changes takes place very long time for the completion is known as slow changes. Fast changes, changes that takes very short time for their completion is known as fast change. This change take within a second, within our minutes. Okay, it take a very short time the changes can occur. Okay, changes can occur in a very short time are called fast changes. These kind of changes takes place within a few seconds or few minutes. For example, blinking of eyes, sneezing, burning of matchstick and then bursting of crackers, explosive and then lightning of electric bulb and then bursting of inflated balloon are example for fast changes. Now can you understand how what is fast change? Okay. Now we are going to discuss the changes based on reversibility. Some of the changes can be reversed and some of them cannot be reversed. So based on the reversibility, the changes can be classified into two types, that is the reversible changes and the irreversible changes. Reversible changes. A change which can be reversed to form the original substance is called reversible changes. Changes occurs only when agents like heat, electricity, and light force etc. applied out to it. Now if the agent causing the change is removed, then in some cases the new substance undergo a change in the reverse direction to form the original substance. Now we say that this is the reversed reaction, reversible change. So suppose it does not undergo the reversible, means it's a irreversible change. Okay, so based on the reversibility, that is a change which can be reversed to form the original substance, is called reversible change. This will become clear from the following example. Ice is a solid substance. When we heat ice, it melts to form liquid water. A change from solid to liquid takes place during the melting of ice. Now, if we cool the water by keeping the freezer or refrigerator, it again changes into solid ice. Thus, the melting of ice is a reversible change. Okay. And then the stretching of rubber band also, and a rubber band spring also, and then inflating a balloon, ironing of clothes, folding of papers, rolling of chapati from its duff, then dissolving of salt, and then dissolving of salt or sugar in a solution. Okay, and then knitting a sweater means we can prepare the sweater from the thread. Suppose we need not the sweater, means we can remove the knot. It may be turned into thread. Okay. And then expansion or contraction. Expansion means when we apply heat, the object goes to the substance. It may be solid or liquid or gas. It turns expand. Okay, wow. The size of the particles expand. When we remove the heat from the substance, it contracts. So expansion and contraction also reversible changes. Okay, so dissolving of sugar in the tea, you can get back the sugar from the tea. Okay, by which method? By evaporation method. So mixing salt and sand, this is also separate by sieving. Suppose we add some water into a mixer of salt and sand. Salt is dissolving in water, sand does not dissolve. So through the sieving method, we can remove the sand from the solution of salt. Then we, using by evaporation method, the water goes to evaporator and then salt is remain in the vessel. So mixing of salt and sand also reversible changes. Now we are going to study irreversible change. A change which cannot be reversed to form the original substance is called irreversible change. For example, if we burn a piece of paper, it changes into ash and smoke. Now we cannot combine the ash and smoke to form the original piece of paper. So the burning of paper is a change which cannot be reversed. In other words, burning of paper is an irreversible change. Some more example for irreversible changes are formation of curd from milk, cooking of food, and then rusting of iron, grinding of wheat grains into flour, and then baking of chapati, and then growth of a plant, and the formation of the flower from bud is also example for irreversible changes. So the cooking process, burning process, rusting, these three processes are irreversible. Cooking does not turn into initial substance. In burning, it does not go to the initial substance. It gives the ash and smoke only. In rusting, iron react with the oxygen in the atmosphere. It gives iron oxide. It does not go to the initial state. Okay. So these are the example for irreversible changes. Next, we are going to study changes based on usefulness. So some changes are beneficial to us, while some of them are harmful to us. So based on their usefulness, we can classify the changes into desirable changes and undesirable changes. Changes which are useful to us are called desirable changes. Some examples for desirable changes are curdling of milk, blooming of flower, cooking of food, construction of buildings, baking of cake, etc. Example for desirable changes, because these changes are useful to us. It is beneficial to us. So they are called as desirable changes. And then some changes are harmful to us. They are not useful to us, are called undesirable changes. Okay. So iron is a harmful change as it damages the iron object. So we try to prevent the rusting of iron object. The various methods we follow, that is painting, galvanization, and then applying chromium metal. These are the prevention of rusting. Okay. So the changes which are not useful to us are called undesirable changes. Okay, student, this is a question time. Now you read the question and prepare to answer the question. Ready for answer for the question. Otherwise, you write the answer in the rough note. In next slide, I show the answer. You check your answers. Okay, this is the answer for your questions. First answer, first question. For the first question, movement of the hands of a clock is a periodic change. Ripening of fruit is a desirable change. And then charcoal burns in a irreversible change. Next, pollution caused by floods is a undesirable change. Change of season can be classified as periodic change. Okay, student, hope all of you understood very well. Thank you, students. This is the assignment for you. Try to study it. Thank you, students.